What's up, guys? Got another tutorial for you. I'm going to show you how to render a kitchen. Let's get right into the video. All right, so right now I do have my image saved. So we click on that image, and I believe I already have some of the settings already the way I want it to. So we're going to go to our environment. And as you can see, we have our settings. So I'm going to change some of these settings to eventually get the results that I want out of this 3D model. And right, and one thing that I actually forgot to do is, so for our image, we're gonna click on the image before I kind of continue going down the settings. I'm going to go to image, and right now we have it at 2K. So I want to go ahead and 4,000. Okay, so that looks better. All right, so we're gonna continue. We're gonna go down our settings, and we're gonna crank up our ambient from 1 to 4. Our white balance, let's do about 4,200. Okay. For the exposure, I think we're good there. We're in this one, we're not gonna have our HDRI environment on. I just don't want that to reflect in my rendering this time. But there are cases that if you want to use your HDR, if you want to have any environments in the background, for this one, I don't need it. So one of the things I like to do to make sure I'm looking straight on, so I always click on my align camera, and that just allows you to make sure that the camera is perpendicular at the angle of the surface of our object. So I'm gonna click on align camera, and I'm gonna click right here in this cabinet. So now we have a good, now we're perpendicular, now we look good, we're looking straight on. This is the view that I want. So I'm going to refresh to make sure that that actually takes place here in our image. And then we're going to click parallelism. We want to make sure that parallelism is always on, depending on the type of view you're trying to accomplish. So here we're going to go to FX, and we're going to play around with our contrast a little bit. Let's see. We are going to put a color gradient on this one. Usually I like to do blue tint, But for this one, we're gonna do, let's do a day midday. We're not gonna do a filter on this one. Put that off. I'm gonna boost up my saturation just a little bit more. Kind of playing with our focal length just a little bit, trying to see how close I actually want to be. Maybe we'll go back to the 54. All right, just want to make sure that tile rendering is selected. As you can see there, when you hover over your options, it just pretty much tells you that it exports at a higher resolution on your images. So definitely want to have that checked. Okay, so for this one, right now we're in real time, and I want to do this as a path tracer. Guys, if you're liking this video, please do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe. And if you got any comments, please leave your comment down below the description box. All right, so we're doing our path tracer here. And as you can see, we are at a medium quality. We're gonna crank that up a lot. I would like to do 3,000. And then we want to do probably 15 max bounces. And fireflies, we'll do 3. Not negative 3. And we definitely want to remove the image noise. Sometimes when, I don't know if you guys notice, if you do a rendering and you have the denoiser unchecked, when your path tracer is finished completing its rounds of trying to unpixelate the image, and if you do not have denoiser checked, then you will still see the noises in the image. So I will always click that, and that kind of reset my path tracer. And I'm going to check my settings while the path tracer is doing its thing. Just want to make sure that I got all my settings correct. Also, guys, you can go on my website at renderreboot.com. This 3D scene will be available on my website for download, so please don't forget to check that out. Also, guys, it is important that you do not forget to hit that like button. I will be doing some more tutorials coming pretty soon, and I do appreciate your support, so please don't forget to hit that like button on your way out. Alright guys, it looked like all my settings are exactly the way I want them, and the path tracer is finishing up, and you'll see the results here in just a second. And there it is. So as you can see, you can get the reflection and the gloss from the refrigerator, and then you have the matte finish on the cabinets, and then you see the texture from the concrete. So this image has come out very well, and I will definitely be showing you some more tips and tricks. So that will be coming up pretty soon, and I appreciate you guys' support, and we'll be back with another one.